Dr. K. S. Ramakrishnan is working as an assistant professor, School of Education, Tamil Nadu Open University, Chennai 15. He has been teaching science education, environmental science, educational technology, and research methodology in various colleges of education and Tamil Nadu Open University for the past 9 years. He has guided so many M.Ed., M.Phil., and Ph.D. students. His current research areas are environmental education, educational technology, and media and communication. He has conducted various workshops on ICT usage in education, Wiki Educator, e-content development, and educational research methodology. He had attended many online workshops on Moodle learning analytics. He has published 6 books and many articles in national and international journals of repute. He regularly gives plenary and keynote speeches on environment and ICT related issues at various national and international conferences. He has delivered 28 episodes of the program Pudiyedor Ulagam at All India Radio, Chennai, related to various new developments in science and technology.
Welcome to UGC CSE program. In this episode, we are going to discuss about the deforestation and biodiversity. First of all, let us see what is biodiversity. So, in this, we are going to discuss about the biodiversity and its components, threats for biodiversity, deforestation, and the reasons for deforestation, and the steps for reducing deforestation. All that we are going to see today. And before that, let us see what is biodiversity. Bio means life, and therefore the biodiversity is the diversity in the life. See the diversity, and therefore the biodiversity is the diversity of the plant and animal species existing in the present environment, and that is called biodiversity. And the biodiversity is the variety of life on earth and the essential interdependence of all living things. And the scientists have identified so far more than 1.4 million species, and tens of millions of species they are still unknown. And the tremendous variety of life on earth is made possible by complex interactions among all living things, including the microorganism. And therefore, only 1.4 million organisms have been so far found, and still some tens of millions are unfound. And see, what are the components of biodiversity? The biodiversity of genes. See, for example, you take the 3 varieties of dogs, Chihuahuas, Beagles, and Rottweilers are all the same species, but they are not the same because there is a variety in their genes. And so, even though all the 3 varieties are the dog variety, there is a difference between their genes, and therefore, the first component of biodiversity is the diversity of genes. And the second component, the diversity of number of species. See, for example, monkeys, dragonflies, and meadow beauties are all different species. See, the monkey, dragonfly, and the meadow beauty. And therefore, biodiversity means the number of species should exist at that particular point. And the third component, that is the variety of ecosystem. Lakes, ponds, and rivers are all the freshwater ecosystem. Rocky coast, sand dune, estuary, salt marsh, coral reef are all the marine ecosystem. And therefore, the biodiversity should have a lot of ecosystem. There should be a variety of ecosystem existing at that particular area. And therefore, an ecosystem means a self-contained community of microorganisms, animals, and plants that interact with each other and with their physical environment, example a rock. And therefore, it is a rock ecosystem, and therefore it contains microorganism, animal, plant, and it is self-sustaining also. And therefore, the third condition for biodiversity is that it should have a variety of ecosystems. And now, what we are getting from biodiversity? Oxygen, second food and clean water, medicine and aesthetic. So, and beyond that we are getting some ideas also, and therefore, these are all the things that we are getting from the biodiversity. And some fact about the biodiversity: the earth is losing the species at an alarming rate. 3 species per hour are going extinct, and 20,000 extinctions occur in each year. And therefore, it is really an alarming thing, because 3 species per hour, that means in every hour that we are losing 3 species, and in each year that we are losing 20,000 extinctions, and therefore, it is a very alarming fact. And when species and plants and animals go extinct, many other species are affected, because in the ecosystem, all the animals and plants, they are interrelated, and therefore, when one species is going extinct, it is affecting the other components of the ecosystem also. And what are the threats to biodiversity? The habitat destruction, and second, pollution, and third, the species introduction, and fourth, the global climate change and the exploitation. And so, these are all the threats. So, we are destructing the habitat and pollution, and some new species are introduced also, and that may not be accepted by the particular ecosystem, and the global climate change and exploitation, all these are some threats for the biodiversity. And it is a human disturbance map, and you look at the map, wherever the green color is there, it is predominantly natural, and yellow, that is partially disturbed, and red, that is human dominated. See, you see, most majority parts of China and North America and South America and certain parts of Europe, they are predominantly very natural. And the yellow portion, some portions of Africa and Asia and North America, and they are partially disturbed, and these portions, and they are predominantly dominated by the human beings. And therefore, it is the map depicting the human disturbance on the various ecosystem or environment. And now, what are the goals of Convention on Biodiversity? And see, there are greater than 1 lakh plant or animal species lost in last 5 years. That means, in the last 5 years, we have lost around 1 lakh plants or animal species. And the habitat loss is biggest current threat to biodiversity. And the deforestation and forest degradation has increased since the Rio Earth Summit. And therefore, what are the goals of conversion that we have to avoid all this, and that are the goals of Convention on the Biodiversity. And see, this map is telling the global biodiversity, the species, the number of vascular plants, and see here, that is a 1 and 2 and 3, the zone 3 and zone 4, and therefore, they are depicted by various colors. And here, it is less than 100, 100 to 200, that means in that particular region, the number of plants or animals, that is less than 100, 100 to 200, 200 to 500, and so on and so forth. And therefore, this diagram is depicting the global biodiversity, and wherever the red color is there, it is more than around some 10,000, and therefore, these are very diverse area, and the remaining, they are less diverse in comparison with this, and therefore, it is telling the global biodiversity diagram. And what are the threats to endangered mammals in Australia and the America. See, if you look at the diagram, the habitat loss, that is the biggest threat, and then comes the exploitation, exotic species and others. And so, this diagram is very clearly depicting that the habitat loss, suppose if a species is losing the habitat, that is one of the major threat, because the problem is that all the species are interrelated with each other, and therefore, when they are losing the habitat, see for example, you take up the squirrel, and the squirrel's habitat is trees, and therefore, when we are cutting the tree, the squirrel may not have any place to go. It may not be knowing how to make a nest, or it may not be knowing how to swim also, and therefore, naturally that it is losing the habitat. And so, the habitat loss, that is the biggest threat for the biodiversity. And here, the second threat is the habitat fragmentation. Suppose the habitat is whole or it is total, and so when we are making that into fragment, and then also there is a discontinuity in the diversity, and therefore, again the habitat fragmentation, that is another threat for the biodiversity. And the system regulator, that is 75% of water is recycled by ET, and 25% of water is lost in the runoff, and therefore, these are the system regulator, that means every ecosystem that is regulated by itself. And therefore, when the groundwater is removed, then the effective runoff, that is also increasing. That means, there is a correlation between the groundwater removal and the effective runoff. So, the more the groundwater that we are removing, the more the effective runoff is also happening. And therefore, the biodiversity is affected by the system regulators as well. And then, let us discuss about the rate of deforestation. And in 1981 to 90, you look at the statistics, it is 0.9% per year. That means 53,000 square miles per year, 21,000 square mile in South America, that means in the Amazon forest, and that is equal to the area of New York City. And by 1988, around 10% of the Amazon had been cut down. And due to the isolation of fragments and in forest or clearing boundaries, that is 16% was affected by the deforestation. And therefore, in one decade, that is 1981 to 90, around 16% of the forest that was affected by the deforestation. Let us have a short break. Welcome back from the break. Now, the annual deforestation rate in the Amazon, that is from 1988 to 2006, you see, it is around some 20,000 kilometer square, and therefore, in 1988, it was at this level, and gradually that it has come down in 1991. And that again the deforestation rates have increased, and in 1995 it has reached the peak, and again that it has started decreasing, and therefore, you can see there is a cyclic motion, that means increasing, decreasing and all. And therefore, wherever the red portion, that is consolidated, and the yellow portion, that is estimated, because the graph was drawn in 2006, and therefore, there is a pattern of deforestation of the Amazon forest. And the Amazon loss slowing in Brazil, and clearly that we have seen that in 1995 only there was a peak, and gradually the amount of deforestation that has been coming down, and it is estimated that it will stabilize in 2020. And therefore, there is a cumulative forest loss, and therefore, that will stagnate around here. Anyhow, that it is a good symbol of the loss of deforestation. And here, actually this diagram is talking about what type of forest, and they are majorly deforested, and therefore here the boreal, temperate and coniferous, actually the light gray portion, that is lost by 1950, and that means that mostly they were affected in 1950s, and the black, that is lost between 50 and 1990, and the dark gray, that is projected loss by 2050. And therefore, in comparison with the projected loss, you can see the loss already happened in 1950, that is too much. That means already a great damage has happened to the environment now. And the tropical forest and other natural habitats greatly modified, and particularly grasslands, and they were easily converted to cropland. And for example, the bananas, coffee, grazing land, and often with the tremendous applications of pesticide, and therefore what happens, the forest is being converted into cropland. And actually this diagram, that is talking about the forest conversion, and it is the undisturbed forest and the regrowing forest, fallow, degraded land, desert, green land, pastures and croplands. And therefore, if you look at the diagram, there is actually wherever the black color is there, that is the degraded lands, and therefore all these portions, and they have been degraded, and certain portion that has been left fallow also, and the green, the amount of green pastures and the croplands, they are coming down, and some portions have become the desert also. And therefore, this diagram is telling the conversion of one type of land into another, and therefore, it is also a major concern, the serious concern of converting the forest into the desert or the fallow. And the forest loss in Asia is directly proportional to human population density and gross national income, because the Asia, the case is somewhat different, because the Asian countries are highly populated. And therefore, as far as Asia is concerned, the forest loss is directly proportional to the human population. And you look at the diagram, the population density, as the population density is increasing, the forest area remaining, that is decreasing. And therefore, there is a reverse correlation between the population density and the forest area remaining. And certain countries like Laos, Myanmar, Vietnam and all, and they are having less population density, and therefore more amount of forest is remaining. And in certain countries like Cambodia, Indonesia and Singapore, as the population density is more, therefore naturally the forest, the remaining forest, that is less. And here the gross national income, and so as the national income is increasing, again the forest remaining is decreasing, because actually for what purpose that people are converting the forest? Because for making the industry or for dwelling places. And therefore, when the forest is converted into the industry and all, naturally the gross national income is increasing, and that is resulting in the forest coverage, that is decreasing. And therefore, there is a negative correlation between the population density and the gross national income and the forest coverage. And what are the causes of deforestation and agriculture? 60% of deforestation is because of agriculture, and the rapid decline in soil productivity, because in agriculture when we are using the fertilizer, naturally the soil productivity has come down, and therefore for increasing the yield, that we have to convert more amount of forest into land, and therefore the rapid decline in soil productivity. And they can be sustainable for 15 to 20 year rotation. And there is inequitable land ownership, that is Brazil, where only 5% of farmers own land. And therefore, as there is a inequity in land ownership, that is also a major cause. And why this deforestation is so devastating? The limiting dispersal and colonization. Birds, mammals and insect that were living in forest interior may not cross this barrier, and the limiting foraging ability of animals, the social organisms, gibbons, orangutan, that forage the intact forest may avoid the open areas and typically will not descend from trees to cross the gap. Actually, every animal, they have certain habits and therefore, they cannot cross the barrier and they cannot come and live in the open lands. And that is one of the major hurdles for the animals. And second, restricting mate availability for the same reason, resulting in fragmentation of the population, because the mating, in the mating season, they need certain particular conditions. When the conditions are not satisfied, naturally the mating may not happen and therefore resulting in less population and limiting foraging ability, and that already that we have discussed at that point. And the changing microclimate, including the light, temperature, wind and incident of fire, and therefore they are also affecting the forest habitat. The deforestation associated edge effect may be perceptible up to some 50 million into adjacent intact forest, and therefore the increased wind exposure and the increased temperature during the day and lower ones at night, and therefore all these the climate parameters, they are also affecting the animals, and that is one reason. And agriculture, as we have already told, actually that a lot of forest coverage has been converted into agricultural land, and in the second diagram that we have we are burning some forest also, and therefore that is affecting the soil and the atmosphere also. And then comes the cattle ranching. 12% of deforestation is because of the cattle ranching, and they are frequently aided by the government subsidies, and 2 trees destroyed for each hamburger. That means for every hamburger, 2 trees are being destroyed, and therefore when a hamburger is made from tropical forest beef, it is equivalent to the loss of 2 trees. And overconsumption in industrialized countries, in industrialized areas or places, that people are over consuming, and the foreign debt, poverty, unequal ownership of land and overpopulation, all these are some more major causes for the deforestation. And the commercial logging, it is causing for 21% of deforestation, and creaming of the most valuable hardwoods, 1 to 2 trees per hectare taken, and widespread damage, and clear cut versus selective cutting. And therefore, the commercial logging, that is also causing for 21% of deforestation. Now, let us see what can be done, what shall we do. There is a need to preserve intact sections of a tropical forest, and there is a need to address the economic needs of lesser developed nations in which all tropical forests reside, and the broad scale commercial and conservation strategies need to be developed. This must take into account the economic and environmental constraint, because the economy and environment both are interrelated. Because the economy of many nations are depending upon the deforestation or the environmental degradation only. And therefore, when we are trying to conserve the environment, at the same time that we have to look after the economy also, and therefore, there must be some measures to be taken for the consensus between the economic and environmental constraint, and buffer conservation zones centered around areas of particular endemism, and other areas can be designated for limited sustainable commercial activities, and therefore the buffer conservation zones must be created, and some other areas may be designated for limited sustainable commercial activities, because in a single day that we cannot change the whole world, and therefore some buffer conservation zones must be created for it. And now let us go for a summary. So, in this episode, the biodiversity and its components, the threats for biodiversity, deforestation, the reasons for deforestation, and the steps to be taken to reduce deforestation have been discussed in detail. Now let us have some questions. First question, mention the various components of biodiversity with some examples. Second, what are the major threats to biodiversity? And third, write the major reasons for deforestation. The forest loss in Asia is directly proportional to human population density and gross national income. Briefly discuss the statement. And the last, how cattle ranching affects the biodiversity. So, with that, we conclude this session and goodbye.